This is the program that shows you the side of police chase videos they didn't want you to see. Bungled arrests, kamikaze crooks and cop-based carnage of all kinds. Welcome to Cops Uncut, the real car crash TV. Coming up in Cops Uncut. A ruthless runaway leads cops up the garden path. SUVs and semi-automatic weapons. And a felon feels the full force of the law. It's a mystery that's challenged philosophers for decades. Which came first, the pickup truck or the criminal? Does having a pickup turn you into a crook, or do all crooks buy pickups? Either way, if you really want to make a career in crime, the pickup is the only set of wheels to be seen in. In fact, it's quite possible that the cops will start chasing you simply for owning one. Now, to confirm your criminal status, all you need to do is something blatantly illegal in front of the pursuing policeman, like driving way too fast. But why settle for one police car when you could have three or four caressing your rump? At this point, you have two options. You can simply stick to the roads and drive around for hours just to wind your pursuers up. Alternatively, if you're feeling adventurous, you could experiment with a spot of off-road action. The pickup was, after all, designed for a bit of rough riding. Start things off gently by driving through a car park or two. And once you've established that a truck is quite good for this sort of thing, you could graduate to something like a university campus.
We're going into college, we got him blocked in.
Basically, there are no limits. So if you see a patch of green behind a fence, simply crash your truck through it into the wilderness beyond. Because whenever you perform your off-roading stunts, be it hospital grounds,
behind a hospital in the grass field,
the local cemetery,
he's gonna go on the cemetery,
or even a golf course, you'll soon have notched up enough broken traffic laws to put you and your pickup at the top of the local most wanted list. But a word of warning, if you decide to test your pickup's all-terrain abilities and lose yourself among nature's bounteous wonders, then remember that squad cars might have a hard time following you, and the police might just lose you.
260 at the corner.
On my way.
The gun plays a much bigger role in both crime and law enforcement across the pond than it does here in the UK. In the US, all cops are equipped with at least one sidearm and receive regular weapons training to hone their skills. This fact does little to discourage most criminals who usually come packing plenty of firepower of their own. All of which makes the average American crime scene a very dangerous place to hang out. Take this routine traffic stop in Texas.
Driver of the vehicle! Shut your car off and roll your window down.
Things could have gone a lot smoother if the suspect had listened more carefully to the slightly complicated police instructions.
All right, reach out of your vehicle with your right hand and open up the door. Keep your hands up. We want to see both your hands. Keep both your hands up in the air. Put both your hands up in the air.
And things would have been a lot less grisly if the man hadn't got out with a gun in his hand.
What do you got in your hands? Put it down! Both hands! Come on!
But he doesn't drop it.
Drop
it! The cops drop him. Shot in the stomach, the guy goes down like a sack of potatoes. But he's not dead, so the police close in on him with their biggest guns drawn, ready in case he's up to anything funny. But this suspect's in no mood for comedy. His injuries might not be fatal, but thanks to the new belly button the police have given him, he's in a lot of pain and needs serious medical help. Not surprising, really, when you look at the size of that gun. Possibly by way of an apology for blowing a hole in him, these two Texan troopers prepare a stretcher while the paramedics tend his wounds. Mercifully, this guy isn't destined to be one of the 30,000-odd gun-related deaths in the States every year. But our advice is still to follow all police instructions, lest you fall foul of those itchy trigger fingers. Unlike other celebrated British innovations like television, Viagra, and the English language, the humble roundabout just hasn't proved a big hit with our American friends. The traffic island is one innovation that our American cousins would appear not to have embraced. Which is a bit of a shame, because if there had been a few more roundabouts on these Los Angeles streets instead of four-way intersections...
This guy is blowing stop signs. He just blew right through that stop sign.
Then perhaps crooks like the guy driving the white Mustang...
Coming up to a blind intersection here. Let's see what happens.
Wouldn't find it quite so easy to ignore all the road markings and street signs...
Oh, man!
...and breeze recklessly straight through junction after junction. The driver's on the hoof from the cops after an earlier incident of police evasion.
And we can tell you that the guy was wanted for failure to yield, a traffic violation.
But his obvious dedication to the task of getting as far away from his pursuing officers as possible...
Really taking off right now.
...is almost certainly a big clue that the fugitive might be guilty of something a little more than a minor driving offence.
He blows right through that stop sign.
Perhaps the Mustang's stolen. Or maybe it's packed full of recreational pharmaceuticals.
Makes a right turn, almost hits oncoming traffic there.
Or perhaps the driver simply has a problem with authority figures. Whatever, the guy doesn't want to get caught.
And we can tell you that he is just completely out of control.
And to get away from the cops, he's obviously quite prepared to risk his life and anyone else's. We hate to say it, but if there had been a nice green roundabout at this junction, then a collision like this would never have happened. But perhaps it's a little too late to start arguing over town planning issues. For the crook, it's time to make a sharp exit.
He gets out of the vehicle, and now it's a foot chase.
And for the cops, it's a game of squash.
The police car hits him.
He's certainly agile.
This guy is on the run, he's desperate, he's trying to get away.
And undeniably fast. But not as fast or indeed as solid or heavy as the crews of the LAPD are trying to run him over with.
He trips over the curb.
This officer jumps at the chance to crush the suspect a bit more. And soon he's started something of a trend. Somewhere under these five policemen, the captive is gasping for air. Now it's the cops' turn to ignore the stop signs. Lying on top of their suspect until he's completely asphyxiated is these officers' roundabout way of saying... You're busted. Still to come on Cops Uncut. Machine gun mayhem on the motorway. And a medical situation of a different kind. Police Academy Lesson 17, Night Patrol. Driving at night is very similar to driving during the day, except it's a lot darker, which is why it's a good idea to remember your headlights. But even with added illumination, you still need to pay special attention to what's going on around you. Which means not driving blindly through stop signs like this one, and staying safely out of the way of large juggernaut-shaped objects. Like that one. Straightforward stuff, you'd have to agree, but let's just go over it again in case you're like the cop in this footage, who obviously didn't pay the slightest bit of attention during his training. So if you're driving at night, don't forget your lights. Remember, even to a cop, this still means stop. And most important of all, try to stay alert or you might get hurt. Class dismissed.
Taking off again.
As getaway transport, the SUV or sports utility vehicle has both pros and cons, as the bank robbers driving this one through Dallas are about to find out. On the plus side, the SUV is roomy, with plenty of space for the driver, a couple of accomplices, and all that loot you've just nicked. On the other hand, the tall design means it's not aerodynamic and not good for outrunning police cruisers. But one good thing about the SUV is that its rear window is perfect to take pot shots at cops. The hail of bullets is more than enough discouragement for the pursuing officer. Clearly shaken, he pulls his squad car over to the side of the road for a little cry. Switching to another cruiser's dashboard camera, there are still plenty of squad cars in pursuit, not all of them going in the right direction. Indeed, only one cop has successfully managed to follow the fugitives down the right slip road. He finds his quarry, but the bank robbers have decided that the SUV's cons outweigh its pros and have dumped it. The guilty threesome have hijacked the white truck seen here, disappearing into the distance. Since he's the only officer in the vicinity, the cop in our cruiser heads off in pursuit of the gun-toting bandits. At first, it looks like the white pickup might just be the criminal's ticket to freedom. But it soon turns out that they aren't really getting on very well with their latest acquisition either. Having crashed the pickup into a telegraph pole, the robbers try to carjack a third vehicle. But then they notice they've got company. The desperadoes open fire again, shattering glass and pinning the lone policeman down. The cop returns fire from his defense position behind the cruiser as the remaining suspects pile out of the truck. But where on earth is his backup? Bizarrely, they're busy besieging the now empty red SUV down the road. The bungling boys in blue run up to the abandoned SUV, weapons drawn, unaware that the real firefight is just a couple of blocks away. It takes them a good few minutes to put two and two together, at which point this well-fed lawman leaps into action like a cleverly painted barrage balloon. At last, the poor cop at the scene of the shootout finally gets reinforcements. Not that they're a great deal of help, because even after surrounding the bank robbers and enthusiastically entering into the gun battle, the stupid cops somehow manage to let all three suspects slip through their fingers. Coming up on Cops Uncut, a praying for paramedics. Big wheels mean big trouble. And a posh car poses a problem. Sometimes a policeman's success during a chase is very dependent on the type of vehicle he's chasing. The brown 80s-style A-team van seen chugging through these Iowa backroads doesn't look like it's going to be too difficult to keep up with.
We're doing about 30 miles an hour.
Particularly when it comes to going uphill. When he gets onto more level ground, the fleeing suspect builds up a bit more speed.
Only doing about 60.
But it's still not nearly enough to outrun the cruiser on his tail. And the faster the driver goes, the more likely he is to lose control of his lumbering great getaway van. Several times along the way, the van looks like it might end up in a ditch.
He's almost lost it a couple times.
So it's not a huge surprise when the fugitives make a bad call on this sharp bend and wind up rolling the thing arse over tip into a clump of trees.
He's 1050
is, of course, a slightly longer police way of saying the word crash. When the cop goes to investigate the wreck, it transpires that the accident was violent enough to throw the driver completely clear of his van.
He looks like he's been ejected.
Thankfully, he's not dead.
He's right here. He's unconscious. Tell him he's unconscious.
But the cop's not taking any chances.
I'm cuffing him up here.
The officer's distrustful nature makes him suspicious to the point of being unreasonable.
Just passed out. He might be taken.
Because whether his prisoner is pretending to be out cold or not, an accident like this surely warrants medical attention of some form. Instead, yet more cops arrive on the scene until it seems like almost half of Iowa's police force have come to run a book on whether or not the comatose van man is a phony. Ah! Traditionally, ambulance drivers are usually called out after an accident. But at the scene of this routine roadside episode in rainy Ohio, the ambulance is the accident. Look at the crash again, and we can see that it could easily have been a whole lot worse. The two cops here and here, for example, managed to leap out of the way in the nick of time. And even the paramedic inside the ambulance is unhurt. In fact, the guy in the black car probably couldn't have picked a better place to crash, because at least this way he won't have a very long wait before the emergency services show up. It's the dead of night. There's been a robbery at a local gas station and the Michigan police have caught up with the suspect. The lights and sirens go on, but shockingly, he's not going to stop. Normally, escape routes for American criminals involve long, straight highways for hundreds and hundreds of miles, but this guy has done his homework and he knows that long highway chases always end in tears. So he hits the back roads. Within minutes, he's on to a dirt track and kicking up dust all through the Michigan countryside. Unfortunately for this bloke, while his escape plan looked great on paper, in practice there may have been a few oversights. The getaway car could have been a little newer, perhaps, more suited to off-roading and ideally capable of more than 30 miles an hour. The second problem area is the route itself. Long, straight highways are definitely home turf for state troopers, so avoiding these was a good idea. But as the chase progresses, our man starts to get a bit cocky and takes a turn off too many, leading him down a tiny, winding track through thick, snowy forests, muddy ditches and streams. This doesn't have to be a problem and may even discourage the cop from following you. What is a problem is if you've chosen a dirt track that doesn't go anywhere, like this one. As he runs out of road, so our hopeless fugitive holds his hands up.
Get your hands up!
When the cops get him to the ground and kneel on his neck, the reason for his wayward wandering becomes clear. He's absolutely smashed. Still to come, high off the road and high on the wanted list. How to get arrested. The crime business is a tricky one to make your name in, and with so many other car thieves out on the roads, it's often quite easy for a budding auto bandit to just blend into the background. If you really want to stand out, then make sure the car you nick is as noticeable as possible. Expensive, black, and European. A posh dark sedan, perhaps. You know the sort, favoured by Italian gangsters and record company executives the world over.
They're bailing out.
Should you later decide to travel on foot, then try running through buildings that haven't been built yet so the helicopters can keep an eye on you, then pick the most rubbish hiding place you can find. If, when you're actually caught, you suddenly have second thoughts about this getting arrested business, simply deny all knowledge. Hopefully the cops won't notice that you're talking out of the back of your head.
Taking off again.
For the police, even when an arrest situation seems to be going quite smoothly, it's worth using extreme caution at all times. Here, three suspects exit their vehicle and adopt the prone position, exactly as the police have asked. But this officer here thinks he hears gunfire and leaps to safety behind his cruiser like a big girl's blouse. Actually, it's only traffic noise, and when he realizes the jumpy officer reattempts his approach, guns drawn. The scrawny cop here is discovered that he's not quite strong enough to carry his torch as well as his pistol and frantically searches for a suitable place to shove it. So far, nobody's attempted any monkey business, but even if your suspects are, like these guys, completely cooperating every step of the way, it's still worth making absolutely sure that no one escapes by putting on those handcuffs nice and tight. And once your subject is safely in bondage, it's time to bend them over your bonnet, grab them by the trousers, and give them a long, hard frisking. Another job well done. That surely deserves a donut or six.
260 at the corner.
On my way.
Phoenix, Arizona, and one of the youngest car thieves on the roads has apparently stolen the biggest car he could find. But the police are on this 14-year-old crook's case, and since the legal age for driving in Arizona is, unusually, 15 years and 7 months, it's safe to say the cops have got him on a whole raft of charges, if they can catch him. But the fledgling felon can barely see over the steering wheel, which might explain why he jumps ship midstream and runs off on foot. The abandoned monster truck plows driverless through a garden fence and smashes into the bonnet of a parked car. The kid scampers through dusty backyards, desperately looking for a place to hide. And it's not long before the cops track him down to his best mate's house, where they cuff the fresh-faced suspect and stuff him in the back of a squad car. He didn't go without a fight, though. Both he and his equally youthful mullet-haired friend, seen here in happier days, are charged with assaulting a policeman and resisting arrest. On Cops Uncut, we've seen several examples of the feds using either a spike strip or the famous pit maneuver to stop runaway criminals from getting away. But in certain chase situations, it's necessary to use a bit of both to bring the pursuit to a satisfactory end. In Utah, the 19-year-old car thief in the white Ford is proving quite a handful. Earlier, the cops deployed the Stinger and successfully blew out the bad boy's front rubber. But the young crook has a very simple solution to this. Just ride around on your rims for a bit. In theory, the moment this kid got out of his car to try and carjack this truck should have been the perfect opportunity for the cops to make their arrest. By now, the lad has made the cops fairly cross, so the troopers select another precision tactic from their repertoire and ram him off the road. Not even being captured seems to have wiped the smug look off the young car thief's face. Sorry, folks, but that's the end of our Cops Uncut holiday camp. Let's take another look at our fun in the sun. Cops tried to nobble this guy's knees. A crook went for a ramble in the countryside. This guy skipped archery and went for shooting. Bad food wasn't the problem for this guy's stomach. And thank God this bloke didn't drive us to the airport. Be careful out there.